Hello everyone, and welcome to another beer review, and welcome to another day in sunny Portugal. It's a hard life, it is. It's a very difficult hard life. But anyway, today we're doing Blonde Ale. This is a 4.5%. It's 25 IBUs. It's again 330ml bottle, and it's Musa Blonde Ale. So let's see what it's like. Any details about it? Just trying to see. Bottled in Portugal, where is it though? I'm not really sure. Is it São João da Talha? I don't know. I think that's where it is. But anyway, that's what it is. It's, yeah. So it's brewed in Portugal. That's all that really matters. And we'll find out where it takes us once we get it poured. You know, so let's see where this is going to take us. Oh, there we go. Looking good. Looking very nice. So, yeah. People on the podcast, nice, crystal clear, light golden colour, straw colour. Smells a little bit of hoppiness there. Maybe a hint of citrus. Not really any pine tones. A little bit of malt, a little bit of grain, and that's really what we're getting. A little bit of piney there, a little bit of citrus, a little bit of back-end bitterness. Not too bad, nice level of sweetness. And overall, yeah, quite refreshing. I think you expect golden ales in Central Europe, in these warm countries, to be again more towards the kind of citrus side of it, a little bit of piney in the flavours and things like that. But I'll be totally honest, I'd rather have that than a bland Spanish lager or things like that. I mean, I did some reviews yesterday and then I had a Sagres afterwards, maybe a couple of hours afterwards, and it was bland and tasteless because of it. Because I'd had the ales previously, and that's the problem. If you put them side by side, well, let's be totally honest, the lagers just can't hold up to it, it really just can't. So, something like this is a better option for me. Is a citrus thing my first choice? Not so much, but I don't find it such a bad thing compared with other people. I don't like it overly, and I don't like piney tones, I just don't. I'm not a big fan of piney tones. But, anyway, let's break down the flavours. Nice bit of malt sweetness, kind of light, kind of golden syrupy tones, bit of grain, nice little bit of sweetness. And you don't really get any of the hops until you get onto the mid-tongue, and it starts kind of coming through with light kind of citrus accent. Sweetness is still the same, malt is roughly about the same. And it's just near the back end of the mid-tongue, you start getting a little bit of piney tones as well. And that kind of ramps up to give you a bit more of a bitterness going into the back of the mouth and the aftertaste. And the last kind of flavours to kind of dissipate is the kind of piney tones and the light citrus accents. And there you go. Quite a simple beer and quite simple flavours. But yeah, quite nice, quite refreshing. But what would I give this out of 10? There's a question. Ah, right. I would probably give this out of 10. I'm going to give this a nice easy 6. It's quite nice, refreshing. The sweetness isn't too much. It's just kind of right. I would say the bitterness and the piney tones and citrus tones is just enough. I don't think it really needs to go any further than that. And after me having a couple of sips, it's kind of died down a bit as your mouth has got acclimatized to it. So overall, quite nice, quite easy drinking. I would recommend this as well. I'm quite surprised with some of the quality of the beers that you're actually getting in Portugal, especially from the kind of more ale side of it. And yeah, fair play to them, well done. So yeah, so it's an easy 6 out of 10. It's roughly about €2.49. It's 4.5%, 330ml bottle. Thanks for watching. Cheers, and bye for now.